You may now be required to pay to watch digital television. That's if the NCA goes ahead with a new policy it intends to roll out. This comes in the wake of a unanimous decision by the Supreme Court that dismissed the case filed by the Ghana Independent Broadcasters Association, challenging the new system, which was to be implemented by June this year, but was deferred. Now, court correspondent Joseph Akable interacted with Gary Nimako, his lawyer for the NCA.
When they filed this case, in respect of claiming that the policy of the Ministry of Communication in trying to introduce a conditional access system is curtailing freedom of expression or that their right to broadcast. We have told them from day one that that position is wrong in law, because at the end of the day, even if that policy itself is even anything to talk about, it has not been implemented. It's not been carried into effect. You understand what I'm saying? So the action itself from day one is premature. We told them from day one that the case is premature and they won't listen to us. And the court has affirmed our position that the action is premature. So that, I think, should be it. In any event, this issue about conditional access system, what is it about? It's a thinking through that government is doing to say, look, let's find a very nice way, a very refined way going into the future, all right, to introduce a system whereby television viewers, you know, can pay TV licenses. You get what I'm saying? So at least to even raise revenue for government in one way or the other. It has got nothing to do with the content of broadcasters, with your content, nothing. Nothing at all. So we don't even see the complaint of GIBA in this matter. You know, so clearly, there's a lot of, you know, misinformation out there that once that policy is introduced, government intends to fetter with their right to broadcast. And that is not correct. That's not correct, you know. So the court agreed with us, and I think that the action is premature, so it's been thrown away.
The court made the point that, I mean, you had already scheduled to implement it by end of year. Are we to understand that?
You see, it is not about rescheduling per se. You see, there's a global trend that now no longer analog system is going to be in operation. I believe you are aware. And now they're all going digital, you know. So it's a global trend. And the global trend, Ghana is not out of the world. We are part of the global community, you know. So the analog system is fading away. What is going to happen is the digital migration. And it's going to happen. But without it, we can't even view television in this country. You understand? And we have already gone in to sign all the documents out there, you know. So yeah, so I don't really see the big deal. For instance, if you are a DSTV subscriber and you have paid your subscription fees, can't you watch your program? Okay, now this one, government is simply saying that for the indigents, people who obviously cannot even pay, they put them on a certain, you know, on a certain lifeline. If you cannot pay and you're indigent, you can still view, but you are viewing digital. And the digital is giving you access, universal access across the whole country, everywhere in Ghana. No longer analog. Universal access, everywhere in Ghana you can view. So really, I don't see the complaint of GIBA